you know, there was a lot of respect going into this project, and I think that's what I really appreciated and I was really drawn to.
Well, I want Calgarians to see the pride of our culture by just the symbolism, the stories.
This here is the first step to having that equality that we've always been looking for.
With the Stoney people, I like to give Calgary the most beautiful valley that I have within me.
Everybody needs a good education to survive in this world. Basically, education is the new buffalo.
The context was about the treaty that we had all signed. So as long as the sun shines, the grass grows, the river flows, and the wind blows. That's kind of what the whole concept is about. And the connection between all of us is that water. You know, we basically drank from the same water. You know, we live under the same sky, we live on the same land. We really wanted to bring together that whole concept that we are all in this together.
My work represents, again, like telling this story, telling this memory, you know, my father passing on a simple skill. And it was really important to him. But, you know, to us, it was just us having family time. But he wanted to show us, like, how to be responsible and, like, be serious, but also, like, to have fun in the river. And, you know, it was, like, showing us, like, how to, like, really plant our weight and, you know, get across safely. For me, I wanted to recreate that, put myself in this situation where, you know, I was as a young kid, but now I'm coming back as an adult. So I wanted to also involve, like, this idea of memory into, like, how it's being printed as well. Having something like a Mylar where it's a little bit more of a delicate paper, you know, your prints like really absorb into it and speaks to memory. You know, you have like either this foggy or like kind of clear idea of this past moment.
Nature and human beings combined together to create the beauty of landscape, wildlife, everything that you see, portraits, you name it. The beauty of nature. That's the most beautiful thing that our eyes can see.
For me, like all the women in my life have, I guess, shown stability. You know, they gave us a stable house. They showed us how to act properly. And they gave us the tools to become a better person. It's never the foreground. You know, the women aren't really shown as important as they should be. And like today's day and age, you know, with the missing and murdered women, and you know, I really wanted to showcase that our women are very much important and we do respect them.
I guess my ideas were modern day children telling stories that they've learned from their ancestors, their forefathers, things like that. So I'm kind of building up scenes of horses, you know, animals sort of that were influential to our people's survival and things like that. I noticed these next generations, the youth are changed. They're not going in following old bad habits when they're more getting into their traditions, learning their language and trying to follow more of their spirituality. So I see the pride a lot more in this day and age. So I'm trying to focus on that in this painting.
Some of the words could be used in libraries or education facilities. Words like learning, reading, writing. Concentrated on the four languages that are prominent here in Calgary, which is Tsuut'ina, Blackfoot, Nakoda, Mi'kmaq language. Language is culture. Culture is language. And if we don't learn our language, we're going to lose our culture. I expect Calgarians to, you know, when visiting the Calgary Central Library, to be able to interact with the art piece.
You know, this experience isn't just Indigenous, that, you know, this is a way for us to kind of bridge those gaps.
Through the visual art, they're seeing our stories, our traditions, our symbols, and showing that pride.
with our culture, it's been so romanticized to the point where they don't really need to have us in the foreground. You know, they just need to have an image of us, and then that's Aboriginal inclusion there. That's it. But I think to have specific ideas about what Aboriginal culture means to us, in especially in the core of the city.
Alberta is the most beautiful I find, and when I'm going away, I miss the mountains. And the mountains are the most breathtaking, and we are taught that have your soul as heavy as the mountains so you wouldn't be disturbed. And we could share that if we have more places like what's happening at the library.